Hello friends, in continuation to the previous lecture, which was about the electrical activity of our heart, and in that we have started with the ECG signal, that is electrocardiogram. And in this lecture now we will see how we are recording ECG signal and what is a system, basically ECG lead system, which is used to record the ECG signal. And then we will discuss about the interpretation of the results, how that ECG wave signal has been interpreted. So let's begin with the introduction to ECG leads. So an electrocardiographic lead is a pair of electrical conductors, and we are also calling it them as electrodes. They are used to measure the difference in electrical potential between either two different points on the body, then we will call them as bipolar leads, or it can be one point on the body and a virtual reference point with zero potential and which is located in the center of the heart. Then we will call them as unipolar leads. So we have two different types of leads. Bipolar leads, that uses two different points on the body, and other is unipolar leads, that is one point on the body and one is the virtual reference, that is having zero potential. These electrodes will detect the small electrical changes that are the consequence of cardiac muscle depolarization followed by the repolarization during each cardiac cycle. We have seen that contraction and relaxation, that is basically due to depolarization and followed by repolarization of atria and ventricles, which corresponds to one cardiac cycle. Now, next, coming over to the 12 lead ECG system, which is used to calculate or to capture or to record the electrical activity of the heart, or we can say ECG signal. So a 12 lead ECG provides information about the electrical system of the heart from 12 different views. So this 12 lead basically corresponds to 12 different views. These 12 leads include 6 limb leads and 6 chest, or we can say precordial leads, that are represented as V1 to V6. Now 6 limb leads, further it includes 3 standard limb leads, which are given as lead 1, 2 and 3 in Roman. And we have basically these 3 leads are bipolar leads, means they need 2 points on the body. And they are arranged like spokes of a wheel in the coronal plane, that is vertical plane. We will see the location of these leads. And then other 3 limb leads are augmented limb leads. Basically, they are represented as AVR, that is augmented vector right, augmented vector left, and augmented vector foot. So these are AVR, AVL, and AVF. These are unipolar leads. If you see the difference, standard limb leads were bipolar leads, but augmented limb leads are the unipolar leads. And then we have 6 chest leads. They are again the unipolar leads, and they lie on the perpendicular transverse plane, that is horizontal plane. So if you talk about standard limb leads, those were lying on the vertical plane, and these precordial leads or chest leads, they are lying on the perpendicular transverse plane, that is horizontal plane. And the axis of a particular lead represents the viewpoint from which it looks at the heart. So that's why we call it is from 12 different views. Now, we will discuss about the placement of electrodes. So we have 10 electrodes. We have 4 limb electrodes and 4 chest electrodes. Don't get confused with leads. We have 12 lead system, this is, but that is because of 12 electrodes. Now you will see how we will place the different electrodes. So what is the placement of limb electrodes? So you can see in this diagram, it is showing we have electrode name as RA, that is right arm, and means electrode is placed on the right arm. So it can be like on the wrist or on the shoulder. So these are two different views you can see. Then we have left arm, which is at the same location where RA was placed, but on the left arm. Then we have right leg, that is on, as I mentioned, you can see green point, that is right leg. And then we have LL, that is left leg, and it is the location where RL was placed, but on the left leg. So these are the placement of standard limb electrodes. And right leg attachment has no value and it will act as earth. Now we will see the placement of 6 chest electrodes. So we have 4 limb electrodes which form the 6 leads, and then we have 6 chest electrodes. We will see how we can place. So don't get confused with leads. We have 12 leads, basically 12 views, but 10 electrodes. So 10 electrodes, we have seen the limb electrodes, how we are placing them. And now we will see the 6 chest electrodes. So first is V1, that is placed in the 4th intercostal space, that is between ribs 4 and 5, just to the right of breastbone. So this is the breastbone, and it is just placed to the right of breastbone. Then we have V2. And it is placed in the 4th intercostal space, that is again between ribs 4 and 5, but that is to the left of breastbone. Now V3, it is placed between the leads V2 and V4, and V4, it is placed in the 5th intercostal space, that is between ribs 5 and 6, in the midclavicular line. So this is midclavicular line. So on that basically line, we are placing this V4 in between ribs 5 and 6. Now we have V5, which is horizontally even with V4 and in the left anterior axillary line. You can see this is left anterior axillary line. So on that line, we are placing V5. And then at last, we have V6, which is again horizontally even with V4 and V5, but in the mid axillary line. So these are the placement of 6 chest electrodes. Now, as I mentioned that these chest electrodes and augmented electrodes or augmented leads, basically those are unipolar leads. So they need a central point, or we can say a virtual terminal. So that is Wilson's central terminal, which act as a common virtual electrode, and it is represented as V subscript W. So how it is obtained? It is obtained by averaging the measurements from the electrodes RA, LA and LL to give an average potential of the body. So it is given as average of these three electrodes, RA, values of these three electrodes, this is RA, LA and LL. So that is Wilson's central terminal or a common virtual electrode. Next we'll see, and this measurement of a voltage requires 2 contact. So as I mentioned, for unipolar leads, they were measured between the common lead, which will act as negative, and unipolar lead, which is positive. We will see when we will further find the calculations and placement of leads. So now we will see the lead placement, or how you can calculating the voltage between 2 electrodes that correspond to lead voltage. So that makes the Enthoven's triangle. So Enthoven's triangle is formed by the lead placement. Now the leads are placed on the right arm, left arm and the left leg. As you can see, 3 leads it is showing: RA, electrode, left arm and left leg. So this will make the placement of leads. Now lead 1, that corresponds to, because now remember we have 12 leads, so what, 3 standard leads 1, 2, and 3. 3 augmented leads, AVR, AVL, and AVF. And 6, we have precordial leads, which again corresponds to 6 precordial electrodes. But these 6 leads of, we can say, limb leads, they correspond to 4 electrodes. So now lead 1 is the voltage that is positive between the left arm and right arm electrode. So lead 1 is the voltage which we are getting from 2 electrodes, that is LA and RA. And in that, LA will act as a positive terminal and RA will act as a negative terminal. So you will get lead 1 as LA minus RA. Now we have lead 2. So it is again the positive voltage, it is at left leg, that is LL, and right arm will act as a negative terminal, so that is RA. So you can see lead 2 is LL minus RA. So in this, LL will act as a positive terminal and RA will act as a negative terminal. Now we have lead 3, another standard limb lead. So for that, we have the positive terminal at left leg and negative at, you can see, left arm. So this is LL minus LA. So this is the placement of 3 standard limb leads, lead 1, 2 and 3, and it makes the Enthoven's triangle. You can see this will make the Enthoven's triangle. Now we will discuss the placement of augmented limb leads. Again, these will use these 3 electrodes only and one virtual terminal, because we know these are unipolar leads. So they will keep one point on the body and one it will take as a reference point. So we have lead augmented vector right, that is AVR. Then we have AVL, that is augmented vector left. Then we have augmented vector foot, that is AVF. So they are again derived from the same 3 electrodes, that is RA, LA, LL, as we have used for lead 1, lead 2 and lead 3. But they use Goldberger's central terminal as their negative pole. Now what is this Goldberger's central terminal? So this Goldberger's central terminal is a combination of input from 2 limb electrodes with a different combination for each augmented lead. You will see how you will calculate that. Suppose lead AVR, it has a positive electrode on the right arm, you can see, and negative pole is a combination of LA and LL electrode. So how you calculate that using Goldberger's terminal? So it is given as AVR is RA minus half of LA plus LL. Now we can also write this in terms of Wilson's terminal. We have seen Wilson's terminal is the average of RA, LA and LL. So if you substitute that LA plus LL by using that relation of Wilson's terminal in terms of the VW, so you can write that equation as 3 by 2 RA minus VW, that is AVR in terms of Wilson's terminal. Similarly, we can calculate AVL, which has the positive electrode on the left arm and negative pole is a combination of RA and LL electrode. So AVL is LA minus half of RA plus LL. Now in terms of Wilson's terminal, we can keep that as 3 by 2 LA minus VW. Now lead AVF has the positive electrode on the left leg, you can see, and negative pole is a combination of RA and LL. So you can keep AVF as LL minus half of RA plus LA, and it is again we can write in terms of Wilson's terminal, that is we can get 3 by 2 LL minus VW. So VW here again it is for virtual electrode, or we can say Wilson's terminal. So this is how we can get the placement of augmented limb leads. So we have seen the placement or the value, how we can get the value corresponding to limb leads in that 3 standard leads, that is lead 1, 2 and 3. And then we have 3 augmented leads, that is AVR, AVL and AVF. Now, you can see this hex axial reference system. Basically, it shows the different values for limb leads. As you can see in this, together these six leads, one lead 1, 2, 3 and augmented limb leads AVR, AVL, AVF, they form the basis of hex axial reference system and it is used to calculate heart's electrical excess in the frontal plane. So you can see in this figure, like this is at 0 degree we have lead 1, then lead 2 it forms the angle of 60 degree, then lead 3 it forms the angle of 120 degree. So these are the three standard leads, and now augmented leads, they are AVF, you can see 90 degree at 90 degrees. Then you have AVR, which is at 210 degrees, and similarly we have AVL, which is at either we can say 150 degree or minus 30 degree. So we have different leads. Basically these are six limb leads which form the hex axial reference system. Now how we can keep the values of precordial leads? So we have seen that we have six electrodes for six precordial leads, and for that we are using the same location. So these leads are placed, these leads are measured at the same location where these six electrodes are there, V1, V2, V3, V4, V5 and V6, and because these are unipolar leads, so again they will use a reference point. So this precordial leads lie in the transverse, or we can say horizontal plane, which is perpendicular to the other six leads. Other six leads means the limb leads. And this six precordial electrodes act as a positive terminal, like V1, V2, V3, V4, V5, V6. And what will be the negative terminal? It is again, we have to use Wilson central terminal as a negative point. So we can calculate the 10 corresponding electrodes we can use to find the values for 12 corresponding leads. Now further coming over to the recording part of this ECG signal, and then we will move to interpretation of the signals. So this is showing a journal block diagram of an ECG machine. You can see, so it consists of a stylus and it run at standard rate of 25 millimeter per second, and for a signal of 1 millivolt the stylus should move 1 centimeter vertically up. So this is a recording system, then means what machine we are using, how it works, and then for recording we should keep some points in mind, that the chest should be dry, patient should be calm with zero muscular activity, otherwise it will contribute to artifact. So this is how we can prepare a body for recording. Now let's discuss about a standard 12 lead ECG report. We have seen that we are using 12 leads, which are, or we can say 12 different source of voltages we are getting. Lead 1 is giving one value, lead 2 is giving one signal, lead 3 is giving one signal, similarly AVR, AVL, AVF, V1, V2, V3, V4, V5, V6. So these are all different signals which are captured from different leads. Now if you see this, so this interpretation of the ECG is about the understanding of the electrical conduction system of the heart. Now again, if you once see this, you can analyze that this a standard 12 lead ECG report shows a 2.5 millisecond or 2.5 second tracing of each of the 12 leads. And if you see, these tracings are most commonly arranged in a grid of four columns. So these are four columns. One column showing lead 1, 2, 3, other column AVR, AVL, AVF, then other column V1, V2, V3. Then we have fourth column showing the voltage corresponding to V4, V5 and V6 leads. So the normal conduction, as I mentioned, it starts and propagates in some predictable pattern, and any deviation from normal is noted as a variation, which can be the normal variation or it can be some result of a particular abnormality or we can say disease. So interpretation of this is understanding the electrical conduction of the heart, whether this is for a normal person as I mentioned, or it can be due to some abnormality. Now there are some specific rules for a normal ECG signal and we'll discuss one by one. So this is just showing a graph. So this time axis, as we have studied in last lecture, that this x axis corresponds to time scale in millisecond and y axis corresponds to amplitude in millivolt. So what is the rule for PR interval? So first rule says that the PR interval should be 120 to 200 millisecond, or we can say 3 to 5 little squares. You can see in this also. So it should be within the range of 3 to 5 little squares, or because we know one small block corresponds to 40 milliseconds. So we are telling it as 120 to 200 millisecond. And the width of the QRS complex, it should not exceed 110 millisecond, or we can say it should be less than the 3 little squares. Now further, the QRS complex should be dominantly upright in leads 1 and 2. You can see basically leads 1 and 2, the QRS complexes are in positive direction, means they are dominantly in upright movement manner. Next rule says that the QRS and the T waves, they should have same journal direction in the limb lead. So we will discuss, we will see in all limb leads. The lead 1 you can see, lead 2 you can see, AVR you can see. So in almost all the limb leads, they should have the same direction. If you see lead 1 and lead 2, they are showing in positive, means upwards direction. And if you see in AVR, both are in downward direction. So it should have same journal direction in all the limb leads, the QRS complex and the T waves, they should show the same direction. Then all the waves are negative if you see in AVR, that is augmented vector, right? You can see these waves are negative. This is the showing the enlarged version of this. So all the waves are mostly in negative side. Now the R wave. The R wave in the precordial leads. Precordial leads means chest leads, that is V1 to V6. So R wave should basically increase in amplitude, or we can say grow up from V1 to at least V4. You see, this is V1, V2, V3, V4. So it is showing the increase in amplitude. That is for normal person we are discussing. Now, another thing you can see, the ST segment should start isoelectric except in V1 and V2. If you see in V1 and V2, it is elevated, but in other almost it is isoelectric, means it is kind of DC or a constant or at a resting potential type. Then we talk about P waves. They should be upright in leads 1 and 2 and also from V2 to V6. So they should be in positive side. They should be at positive direction. So you can see lead 1 and 2 and also V2 to V6. Then another point is there should be no Q wave or only a small Q, that should be less than 40 millisecond in first second, you can see, and V2 to V6. So that should be less in width, we can say. Now another is for T waves. The T waves should be upright, as you can see, in one lead 1, lead 2 and lead V2 to V6. So T wave should also be upright in these directions. Now last one more thing we can understand in this. So these were some rules. Now how we can measure the heartbeat? So how we can calculate the heartbeat? We can use two consecutive hours. You have seen the QRS complex, as you can see, this is 1 hour, 2 hour. So we can keep these 2 hours in reference, and the number of small squares or large squares you can count in between. And if you are counting the large squares, then 300 divided by the number of large squares between these consecutive R will give us the heartbeat. Or if you talk in terms of small squares, it is 1500 divided by the number of small squares that will give us the heartbeat. So this is how we can calculate heartbeat from the ECG signal. Fine. So this is all in this lecture. So we have seen what are the different rules corresponding to ECG signal and how we can record the ECG signal using 12 lead system, or we can say 10 electrodes. And 12 lead means we are using 12 different views or 12 different signals we are capturing using those 10 electrodes. This was all in this lecture. Thank you so much.